ಹಲೋ ಎವ್ರಿವನ್, ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಐ ಕ್ಯೂ. ನನಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕವರ್ ಜುಲೈ 2017 ಟು ಜನವರಿ 2018, ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೇರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ 6 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಲೈಫ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ 4th of February. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ 4th of February ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ KPSC ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. So this will be very useful. 6 months current affair, complete, very very detailed. Okay, so I'm starting in English language. We also have pen drive courses for UPSC and test series. In case you want to buy it, just go to website studyiq.com. We have also a sale from 23rd to 27th of January. That is a Republic Day sale. You can connect with me on Instagram. My ID is Tireless Soul. Or you can follow me on Twitter. One advantage of following me on Twitter is that you will not miss any notification because each and every video link is shared on Twitter. So let's start. Neelamani Raju, she became first woman to head Karnataka Police Force. She is a 1983 batch IPS Indian Police Service Officer from Uttarakhand, and she is the first woman to lead the police force in Karnataka. And the State Home Minister, Mr. R. Ramalinga Reddy, he announced the appointment of Neelamani N. Raju as the new DGP. You know, new Director General and Inspector General of Police, that is DGIGP, which is a post which is unique to Karnataka. So in most of the states, the DGP is the top police post, but in Karnataka, DGIGP is the top post. So Neelamani Raju is the first woman to head the Karnataka Police Force. There was an elephant survey that was conducted. So elephant survey showed that Karnataka has the highest number of elephants in India. That is 6049 elephants are in Karnataka. And second number is Assam, that is 5719, and third is Kerala. So Karnataka has a lot of important wildlife sanctuaries and national park like Anshi National Park, Banargatta, Bandipura, Nagarhole, it has Kudremukha, Dandeli Tiger Reserve, etc. And Assam also has a lot of important wildlife sanctuary and tiger reserve, like for example Manas National Park, Kaziranga National Park, Orang National Park, Nameri National Park, Sonai Rupai National Park, Dibru Saikhova National Park, etc. And then third is Kerala, which has like Pambadam, Shola, Silent Valley National Park and Periyar National Park and all that. So number one is Karnataka in terms of number of elephants. In fact, Karnataka state animal is also Asiatic elephant. And Assam is second and Kerala is third. So this was the first ever synchronized All India elephant population. Synchronized. This word is important. So the total Asian elephant population in India is around 27,312. By the way, there was also a tiger survey that was conducted, and Karnataka has the highest number of tigers in India also, followed by Uttarakhand. So Karnataka has maximum number of tiger also and elephant also. The last such survey was conducted in 2012, elephant survey, and that time the elephant number was much more than this time. But then the experts say that the parallels cannot be drawn because last time there it was not a synchronized survey, and that is why there were a lot of errors and duplication. Now there is a, you know that Karnataka is the coffee state of India, right? 70% of India's coffee is we get from Karnataka, okay? So in Karnataka, the maximum coffee is in Kodagu, then second is Chikmagaluru. Kodagu, Chikmagaluru, these are very, very popular for coffee cultivation. 70% of India's coffee is in Karnataka, 21% is in Kerala. So if they ask which is the second coffee growing state in India, the answer is Kerala. The number one is Karnataka. Now there is a very different type of coffee which is made from the poop of civet cat. Poop basically means your feces or excreta that you go and relieve yourself. No. So what they do is they take the coffee bean and they make this cat, civet cat, eat those beans. Now civet cat does not eat the bean but only the flesh of the bean. And the enzymes which are present in the body of the civet cat, they kind of increase the flavor of the bean. And that is why this coffee is one of the costliest coffee in the world. So remember that civet cat coffee has been started in Karnataka now. It is also called Luwak coffee. So Luwak coffee. Now what is the price? You can see here it is sold as high as 20 to 25,000 per kg in foreign countries. And the brand name is Einemann. Einemann is the brand name. In India also it is sold at around 8,000 rupees per kg. Karnataka is taking the help of Finland for startup incubation. Lot of states, they are having their incubator now. For example, Telangana, it recently started a V hub and a T hub, right? V hub and T hub, they both are for Telangana. Even Karnataka has its own incubator, and for that it is taking a help for information technology and biotechnology of Finland. Finland is a Scandinavian country, and there will be mutual exchange of information, research, innovation, skill development, and so on. And together, both the countries will also take up some joint project. Now, you know that one famous company of Finland is Nokia. So, Karnataka-Finland Innovation Corridor will also explore some mutual cooperation. For example, there is a Karnataka-based iSamarth program. Samarth means able or skilled. It is initiated by Nokia. Now, Nokia is owned by Microsoft. Remember that. So, this is, they will, do the research on artificial intelligence, machine learning, Internet of Things, and these things. Airtel has launched Office in a Box connectivity solution for Karnataka startups. This is for startups. It's a Karnataka government's initiative. For those startups which are under the Karnataka government startup initiative, Airtel has launched Office in a Box, which will provide a lot of services like data solution, audio web collaboration, SMS, MMS, email service, invoice, IVR, USSD service, and many services. Ola has also tied up with Karnataka Tourism. Now, Karnataka's tagline is one state, many worlds, right? So Ola's founder is Bhavish Agarwal. He is the CEO of Bhavish, Ola. So Ola has tied up with Karnataka Tourism Department to launch tourism campaign. And this tourism campaign is called Ghumo Responsibly, which means you roam around responsibly. So this you need to remember. And also famous actress Shehnaz Treasury, she kind of took out a road trip for 14 days across the state to promote Karnataka tourism. Bengaluru, the capital of Karnataka, which is also called Science City because it has Indian Institute of Science. It is also called Space City because it has headquarters of ISRO. So Bengaluru is ranked world's most affordable tech hub. Bengaluru. And world's most affordable technology hub is Bengaluru. Second is Gurugram, which has the headquarters of International Solar Alliance. And this was done by a company called Knight Frank. So in Bengaluru, the eastern wheatfield area in the eastern Bengaluru is the most affordable technology district. The rent is only 632 rupees per square feet. And Gurugram is the only other which is featured. So it is just costlier. It is in fact twice costlier, but it is still very affordable. The costliest in the world is Zurich, which is in Switzerland. It's a city. This is the costliest. Now, Karnataka is building a Harohalli Industrial Park. This will be in the Ramnagar district of Karnataka, and it has got the green signal. It is at a cost of 1561 crore rupees, and this will the proposal was accepted by Karnataka Industrial Areas Development Board. So they are building this park in a space of 900 hectares, and they have also got the environmental clearance for the same. So remember that Harohalli Industrial Park will be in Ramnagar district of Karnataka at a cost of 1561 crore rupees. The famous actor and filmmaker Prakash Raj, he has received the Karant Award. So he received the Karant Award, Kota Shivaram Karant Hattura Prasasti. So he is in the news because, that he is having some kind of a tussle with Pradhan Mantri Modi on the murder of Gauri Lankesh. He said that, he is making many speeches these days. So this award was started by the Kota Thuttu Gram Panchayat in Udupi district of Karnataka. It is given in the memory of Gyanpeet Award winner, late Dr. Kota Shivaram Karant. It was first given in 2005 to former Union Petrol Minister, Mr. Virappa Moili. And this year it has been given to Mr. Prakash Raj. 7th edition of Rashtriya Sanskriti Mahotsav 2018, it was held recently in Karnataka from 14th to 20th of January. And this was conducted on the theme of Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. So, and it was attended to by our Union Minister for Chemical and Fertilizer and Parliamentary Affairs, Shri Anant Kumar, and Union Minister of State for Culture and Environment, Dr. Mahesh Sharma. So, don't confuse Anant Kumar with Anant Hegde. Okay, both are different. So, Dr. Mahesh Sharma is the Minister for Culture and KG Alphonse is the Minister for Tourism. They are different. So, don't confuse the two. Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. It was started by Pradhan Mantri Modi on 31st October 2016 to promote promote the culture of different states, that is cross culture promotion, and so that India is a pluralistic country, it's a diverse country, unity in diversity, and the state that is paired with Karnataka is Uttarakhand. So Karnataka and Uttarakhand, they will promote each other's culture. Karnataka government will obtain electric vehicles under the FAME India scheme. What is the full form of FAME? FAME means faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles in India. Clear? hybrid and electric vehicles in India. We want faster adoption and manufacturing. It is called FAME India scheme. So, and Karnataka State's industry minister is R.V. Deshpande. So, Karnataka will procure 40 electric buses. Procure means buy. Karnataka will buy 40 electric buses, 100 four-wheeler and 500 three-wheeler. And they will also set up charging infrastructure in Bengaluru for charging these. In fact, there are four things in this. We need technology development. These are the focus area of FAME India. Demand creation, pilot project and charging infrastructure. So, charging infrastructure will be set up in Bengaluru. Now, what is the provision of this scheme? Under this scheme, subsidy is provided to an extent of up to 60% of purchase cost on electric buses, 1.24 lakh rupees for every electric four-wheeler and 61,000 rupees for every electric three-wheeler by the central government. I repeat once more, 60% of up to 60% of the subsidy is provided if you buy electric bus. If you buy electric four-wheeler, then up to 1.24 lakh rupees and rupees 61,000 subsidy is given for every electric three-wheeler by the central government, not by the state government. Okay. And subsidy is also provided for if you want to create a charging infrastructure like the Karnataka government is making charging infrastructure in Bengaluru. So you have to remember this. And this scheme will be in many phases, phase one, phase two, like that. So phase one already started from 2015-16. This scheme was launched. This scheme came into effect from 1st of April 2015. And we are basically incentivizing all the types of vehicle. And there are many technology available like mild hybrid, strong hybrid, plug-in hybrid and battery electric vehicle. Now there is a place in Karnataka, Tirathalli Taluk. There is monkey fever that is spreading there. Okay, monkey fever affects the monkeys and the langurs. It is caused by, it is also called Kayasanur forest disease, also called monkey fever. So a lot of monkey deaths have been reported. And recently 5 deaths were reported in the village of Gan Teja Nagallu near Suruvina Koppa village. Monkey fever, it is called monkey fever because if it affects black faced langur and red faced bonnet monkey. Clear? What is the name of the virus that causes this disease? It is Kayasanur forest disease virus, also called KFDV. Okay, remember that. And this virus causes hemorrhagic symptom like bleeding from nose, throat, gum of the monkeys. There is GIT bleeding, gastrointestinal bleeding from intestine, muscle stiffness, tremor, and finally death. Now, India and Maldives, they conducted a military exercise which is called Equivarin. It takes place, this was the 8th time that this was conducted. The word Equivarin means friendship in Maldives language. Okay, so this was conducted in Belagavi in Karnataka. And there was mutual cooperation and they focused on counter-insurgency, counter-terrorism operations, etc. So the word Equivarin means friends in the Maldivian language. Asian Development Bank is headquartered in Manila, which is the capital of Philippines, and Asian Development Bank Takehiko Nakao is the president. Takehiko Nakao of Japan. Now in Asian Development Bank, the highest share is of Japan, followed by America, followed by China, and fourth is India. So India has the fourth highest share in ADB. Now ADB is giving a loan of $346 million to upgrade the Karnataka highway. So $346 million loan to upgrade Karnataka highway, and this will improve 419 kilometer of Karnataka highway. They will be upgraded from 2-lane to 4-lane, etc. And this is second funding of ADB to Karnataka. Overall cost of this project is 655. How much is ADB giving? 346. What about the remaining amount? So the state government, that is the government of Karnataka, will invest 202 million and the private sector investment will be 107. So if you add everything, it becomes 655. And this project will be completed by 2023. Supreme Court has refused to stay the PETA plea to ban Kambala. So what is the matter? So the thing is that, see, Jallikattu is there in Tamil Nadu. Okay, Jallikattu. Similarly, Kambala is a buffalo race which is conducted in Karnataka. And similarly, there is cockfighting which is in Andhra Pradesh. These are three important animal sports in India. Cockfighting in Andhra Pradesh in Krishna, East Godavari and West Godavari district. Then you have Kambala buffalo race in Karnataka and Jallikattu in Tamil Nadu. Okay. Now this is very important for the culture, for maintenance of the culture, because there are a lot of regional sentiments and cultural sensitivities that are involved. But PETA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, this is an organization which said that there is cruelty. So they took the matter to the Supreme Court, and first there was an interim order from the High Court to ban it. But then what the Karnataka government did was that it kind of exempted it for, you know, from the clause of animal cruelty, because it is very important for Karnataka, especially rural area. And it is still being conducted. So now Supreme Court has refused to stay. Stay means put a ban or refuse peta plea to ban Kambala. So again, Supreme Court is supporting peta in this matter. Now, Karnataka Assembly passed an ordinance that is prevention of cruelty to animal. They modified, amended it to allow Kambala to circumvent the ban imposed by the Karnataka High Court. But now the matter is in the Supreme Court, and if Supreme Court bans Kambala, then it will be very difficult for Karnataka government to do anything about it. So Kambala is a contest where two pair of buffalo, they are tied plow, were made to race on a slush filled track, that is muddy track, with a jockey guiding them while they run. Now the buffaloes, they run at a very fast speed, and the farmers use a whip to whip on their back to make them run. And the Kambala season starts in somewhere in November, and it lasts till March. Now the problem is that, you know, like the whip, it shows cruelty. Also the nose of the buffalo, there is a rope that also shows cruelty. The winning pair of buffalo in early days were awarded coconut, but these days medals are given, gold medal and trophies etc. are given. Now I told you that Asian Development Bank gave a loan for upgrading of roadways in Karnataka. One more loan Karnataka has got. This is from again Asian Development Bank. This loan is 65.5 million and this is for coastal protection in Karnataka. So you know that Karnataka has a lot of important ports. You know, it has a coastline and it touches the Arabian Sea. So this is the western coast of, this is Karnataka. Okay, this is Maharashtra, this small is Goa, then this is Karnataka. This is the western coast of India. And Karnataka, there is Mangaluru port, for example, there is Karwar. So the coastal protection is very, very necessary. So 250 million overall is the loan that is required, and ADB is giving 66.5. This is the second part of the loan. This is the second tranche of the loan. So it will provide this loan in four parts, 65 into 4, that is 250 million. Is it clear or not clear? And this will also augment the institutional capacity of Karnataka's Public Works, Ports and Inland Water Transport Department. The second tranche loan resource, you know, for ADB's ordinary capital resources is a 20-year term. And these are some of the important ports. The only major port is the New Mangaluru port, but there are minor ports. So they are located at Karwar, Old Mangalore, Belakari, Tadadi, Onavar, Bhatkal, Kundapura, Hangarakatta, Malpe and Pudubidri ports. These are the small ports in Karnataka. So there is about 54 kilometer of coastline that will be protected with the help of this loan. There is a boat by the Indian Coast Guard. Indian Coast Guard Rajendra Singh is the Director General or Chief of Indian Coast Guard, which takes care of our coastline. In India, Gujarat has the longest coastline, followed by Andhra Pradesh. So V-409, it is the name of a boat. It was launched recently in Mangaluru. It is an interceptor boat. So it was launched in Mangaluru, Karnataka by Bharati Defence and Infrastructure Limited, BDIL. So this is a very powerful boat. It has a length of 28 meter, beam of 6 meter and draught of 1.2 meter. It has aluminium hull. So this has the capability of attaining very high speed in a very short amount of time. And this will have 12 sailor and one officer. Karnataka has done a tie up with Microsoft company to develop India's first farm price forecasting model. I repeat, farm price forecasting model. What exactly this is? This is first in India. It will help the farmers from Karnataka state to predict the farm prices in advance, you know, much earlier, so that they can deal with the unpredictability of the prices, because as such farmers, they don't get minimum support price. So this farm price forecasting model, now the name says farm price forecast, you are forecasting the price so that it helps farmer. It will use the information technology and all the technology that Microsoft provides to Karnataka. It will also provide real-time market data like the rate of the crops, etc., so that farmers can make an informed decision regarding the same. Karnataka government has launched cloud seeding project, which is called Varshadhari. This is super important. See, what happens is Karnataka, although there is a lot of rain because it is on the western coast of India, lot of rain. But the problem is at a lot of places, rain may not be as per the expectation. So what they do is they spray silver iodide. okay, which is, you write it like this, AGI. AG means silver, I means iodine. Silver, iodide is the chemical, they spray on the cloud. So what happened? This is a cloud. So if it has less water, it kind of shrinks the cloud and therefore forces the water to get out of the cloud, and it causes rain. This is called Varshadhari project, and the cost is 35 crore rupees. The budget allocated for that is 35 crore rupees. So this cloud seeding project started in Magadi and Ramanagaram. Ramanagaram and Magadi. And it will condense or shrink small water particle by cloud less than 10 micron, and so that artificial rain can occur. There is another scheme in Karnataka which is called Surya Reta. Surya Reta scheme is to provide solar water pump. Okay, solar water pump you charge in the daytime and you don't need electricity during the night time. It will save money of farmer. So Surya Reta scheme is to provide solar water pump and replace the normal IP pump, you know, the irrigation pump, IP pump. These will be replaced by solar pump. So they have started this in Kanakapura. They started it in Kanakapura on 19 January 2018. Also, these solar water pump are very efficient. Their capacity, you know, is 1.5 times, you know, pumping capacity is more than 1.5 times that of the ordinary IP pumps. And these pumps will supply 1/3 of the total energy to the electricity grid also, the nearby electricity grid. So it will help farmer in irrigation purpose. So farmer don't need, need not switch on their IP set during the night, because whatever is the energy that is generated during the daytime will be used during the night time, provided the sunshine should be good. Now remember that International Solar Alliance was created by the effort of India and France at the COP21 Paris conference. It is headquartered in Gurugram in Haryana, and India is taking a lot of important decisions with respect to same. India's renewable energy target is 175 gigawatt or 175,000 megawatt, because 1 gigawatt is equal to 1000 megawatt. So 175 gigawatt is the target by 2022, and out of that 100 gigawatt is solar power, and 60 is wind power, 10 is biomass, and 5 is hydropower. So all together it forms 175 gigawatt. This is a very ambitious target by 2022. This program will be seen by BSECOM. And Karnataka Electricity Regulatory Commission will also fix the tariff with regard to the solar power. Now, farmer will have to give shadow-free land to successfully install such system. And this scheme started in Kanakapura. Also, Karnataka government will form the Arobel Surya Reta Vidyut Chakti Balakedarara Sangha Niyamita Society for the successful implementation of the pilot project. And also remember that the department has also set up world's largest solar park at Pavagada in Tumukuru district. Tumukuru, Pavagada, at Pavagada, world's largest solar park. There is another scheme in Karnataka which is called Karnataka Indra Vastra Bhagya scheme. Vastra means cloth, Bhagya, okay. Vastra Bhagya scheme to provide free sari and shirts for below poverty line family. This is not for everyone, this is only for below poverty line family. And usually to determine below poverty line family, we use the socio-economic caste census of 2011. So this is called Indra Vastra Bhagya scheme, where the state government will provide free sari and free panches to the poor household. So these are the economically weaker section of the society, and there are around 1.1 crore people in Karnataka which are below poverty line. They will benefit from the scheme. Now Karnataka government, this is called Vastra Bhagya, okay, but Karnataka government is also already running scheme like Anila Bhagya, Shira Bhagya, which is the milk, Shira Bhagya, Laptop Bhagya, all these schemes. And Karnataka government will spend 550 crore rupees for the scheme. So these are some of the important features. First, the scheme will provide free sari and panches to the people belonging to the below poverty line family. So men will get a set of poly cotton panch and poly viscose shirt piece. In addition to this, women will get polyester sari and poly cotton blouse piece. So this scheme will benefit the household whose livelihood depend on handloom sector, as the government will directly procure or buy these clothes from weavers at appropriate price. And the state government will launch this scheme on the lines of Indira Gandhi Sari Dhoti scheme. Recently, if you remember, Tamil Nadu government has also started something similar. It is called Free Sari Dhoti scheme, you know, on the occasion of Thai Pongal in Tamil Nadu. So the Karnataka government will also launch it very similar to Tamil Nadu government. There is another scheme for schools and health in Karnataka, which is called Siddha Sarkarada Nade Savagala Kade scheme. Okay, Siddha ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ನಡೆ ಸವೆಗಲ ಕಡೆ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಫಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್, ಅಂಗನವಾಡಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದೀಸ್ ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ 406 crore ರುಪೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ 2018 ಅಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ನಾವ್ 2.5 months ರಿಮೇನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಮನಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ 406. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್. ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ 243 crore. ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ 2719 ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ ಇನ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್. 122 crore ರುಪೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ 309 ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವುಮೆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ 40 crore ರುಪೀಸ್, ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 346 ಅಂಗನವಾಡಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಶ್ರಮ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಶ್ರಮ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ, ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಶ್ರಮ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಶ್ರಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲೇಬರ್, ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಟೂಲ್ ಕಿಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೂಲ್ ಕಿಟ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನ್ಹಾನ್ಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಹಾನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್. ಸೊ ದ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 100 crore ರುಪೀಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದ ಶ್ರಮ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಅಂಡ್ 37,440 ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೈನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಂದಿರಾ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್. ಇಂದಿರಾ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಇಯರ್ January 1, 2018, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಚೀಪ್ ಫುಡ್ ಟು ದ ಪುವರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಟು ದೀನ್ ದಯಾಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು. ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್. ಮೇನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಚೀಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ಫುಡ್ ಟು ದ ಪುವರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೇಬರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕನ್ಸಂಪ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 1 January 2018, ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ₹185 crore ಫಾರ್ ಸೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಇಂದಿರಾ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ತಾಲೂಕಾ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಬಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಸೊ ಎಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಇಂದಿರಾ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್? ಎವ್ರಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ತಾಲೂಕಾ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಬಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ದ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ 1 January 2018, ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಚೀಪರ್ ಫುಡ್ ಅಟ್ 246 ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ 170 regions ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ 9 crore ರುಪೀಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮಂತ್ ಆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್. ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ದಿ ಅಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಡೇಟಾ, ಅರೌಂಡ್ 1 lakh ಪುವರ್ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ಡೈಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಥ್ರೂ ಇಂದಿರಾ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್. ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಗುರು ಚೇತನ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ದ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ಗುರು ಚೇತನ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ದ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡೈಟ್ ಬೈ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದ ಯು ನೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೂ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅ ಬೆಟರ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ 50,000 ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಕ್ವೋಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್. ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಟು 1,400 ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ಅಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ 1,400 ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೈನ್ಡ್. ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಾತೃಪೂರ್ಣ. ಮಾತೃಪೂರ್ಣ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ವುಮೆನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಏಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 1 ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಮೀಲ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ವುಮೆನ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೂರಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಇಸ್ ರನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವುಮೆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್, ವಿಚ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವುಮೆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್. ಸೊ ಯು ದ ಫುಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೈಸ್, ದಾಲ್, ಸಾಂಬಾರ್, ಗ್ರೀನ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್, ಪಲ್ಸಸ್, ಆಗ್, ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ನಟ್, ಜಾಗರಿ, ಚಿಕ್ಕಿ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ನೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ವುಮೆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೂರಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮೆಟರ್ನಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಲೋ. ಎಸ್ಟಿಮೇಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಈಸ್ 21 rupees ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪರ್ ಮೀಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ ಫುಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಮೀಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 15 months, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 9 month ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆನ್ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗೆಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ವುಮೆನ್ 9 months ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ ಯುಟ್ರಸ್ ದ ಬೇಬಿ ಗ್ರೋಸ್. ಸೊ 9 months ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆನ್ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ 6 months ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಚುರೇಷನ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಬರ್ತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೇಬಿ. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್ 15 months ದ ಮೀಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ 2016 ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇಯರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ವುಮೆನ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ವರ್ಡ್ ತಾಲೂಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ 42 crore ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಮಾತೃ ಪುಷ್ಟಿ ವರ್ಧಿನಿ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಮಿಷನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾತೃಪೂರ್ಣ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ will be started on the scheme has already started on October the 2nd, 2017 at all the Anganwadi center across the state. Another scheme by the government of Karnataka is Sankalp Dinda Siddhi program. It was launched by Pradhan Mantri Modi. This is to empower the farmer of Karnataka. So this program was organized by the University of Agriculture Science at Harobelawadi village in Dharwad Taluk of Karnataka. So under this Sankalp Dinda Siddhi program, government will provide many opportunity like adequate water, quality power supply, etc. to double the income of farmer till 2022. 2022 is the deadline. It is the year by which Narendra Modi wants to double the income of the farmer. And the government will also encourage the farmer to adopt online procurement system. And that will be undertaken through the Food Corporation of India. Another scheme is Arogya Bhagya. Arogya means your health. So it is a free medical assistance scheme. This has been launched by the government of Karnataka. Arogya Bhagya scheme for providing free medical treatment to the poor people across the state. So the target which they have kept, the government of Karnataka, is 14 million state household. As a part of the universal health coverage, target is 14 million. So free healthcare service for the economically and socially backward classes in the state. So target is 14 million. Let me tell you some more details about it. The scheme started on 1st of November 2017 at the Kannada Rajyotsav Day in all the districts of the state. And the Aadhaar card is important. It is necessary for the Aadhaar card will be linked to your universal health card to avail the scheme. And the state government has merged 7 different existing scheme in the Arogya Bhagya scheme. Is it clear? The scheme will provide benefit to everyone, BPL also and APL also, above poverty line, below poverty line, both. And it is in private hospital also and public hospital also. Now these are the 7 scheme which have been merged with the Arogya Bhagya scheme. Rajiv Arogya Bhagya scheme, all these have been cancelled now, and all these have been merged with the Arogya Bhagya. So now there is only one scheme, Arogya Bhagya. Vajpayee Arogya Shri scheme, Mukhyamantri Santwana Hari scheme, Yashashwini health insurance scheme, Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram, Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana, and Jyoti Sanjeevani scheme. All of these are now one, Arogya Bhagya. So according to the notification, official notification by the government of Karnataka, Arogya Bhagya scheme, the free healthcare facility will be provided in 2 categories for the needy household. In the first category, 10.5 million household will be covered from different category like farmer, Anganwadi worker, SCST, media professional, teachers, public servant, sanitation worker, and so on. How much money you have to pay? It depends whether you are living in rural or urban area. You have to pay per year 300 rupees if you are in rural area and 700 rupees per person per year if you are in the urban area. This is your insurance premium to avail the benefit of the scheme. Now, home healthcare services under the National Health Campaign are to be launched in Karnataka. So Karnataka Health Department is introducing home healthcare service under the National Health Campaign with the help of Public Health Foundation of India in Hyderabad and Karnataka region. Under this scheme, poor families in selected 6 districts, they will get free home healthcare services. The primary health services will be provided by the health department at their doorstep. Is it clear? At their doorstep. And 6 districts, poor families in selected 6 districts will get free home healthcare services. So this is the aim is to eliminate disease from India. By the way, let me tell you that India has eliminated 2 diseases in 2017, completely eliminated. One is an eye disease called trachoma. Okay. And second is a cattle disease called Rinderpest. Rinderpest has been eliminated from India. It is a cattle disease, and trachoma is an eye disease. It has also been eliminated from India in 2017. However, Kala Azar, which is caused by Leishmania donovani, Kala Azar has not been eliminated, and the government's target was 31st December 2017. They were not able to eliminate this. Now, 3 more diseases you need to know. India's target to eliminate HIV/AIDS is 2030. Okay, 2030. Malaria, India's target to eliminate malaria is 2027. And India's target to eliminate tuberculosis is 2025. So what will be there in home healthcare service? What type of services will be provided at your doorstep? They will provide medicine for flu, vomiting, diarrhea. Diarrhea means loose motion. So diarrhea related disease. And also many problem related eye, nose, throat, teeth and cancer. Free health checkup for the diabetes, blood pressure, hemiplegia. Hemiplegia means when half of the body is paralyzed. Lung disease, they will be covered under the scheme. Also healthcare services will be provided for pregnant women and children. And gradually, this will be implemented in all the districts. And under this scheme, the state health department will provide fund to modify 105 sub-health center in Mysuru's T. Narsipura and Raichuru's Lingasuguru Taluka. So, the department will hire 105 BSc nursing graduate as Medicare assistant, and the eligible nurse will be trained for 6 months through the IGNU Bridge course. So, after completing the course, the Medicare assistant will provide the service at patient's home. This is important. So, this will not it will not require hospitalization. Now, this is something interesting. See, everybody kind of smoke cigarette, you know, youth of today. So what the Supreme Court said, there was a warning that, you know, that cigarette is injurious to health. Earlier there was a rule that 85% of the cigarette pack will have warning, large picture warning, okay, pictorial warning, 85%. But Karnataka High Court decreased it to 40%. The matter went to Supreme Court, and Supreme Court put a stay on the Karnataka High Court order. So Supreme Court again restored it to 85%. This is very important. And the earlier direction that 85% of the cigarette pack will have warning was given by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare in 2014. But the Karnataka High Court, it quashed, and it said up to 40% is required, not 85. But Supreme Court has again said it is 85 that is required. So it's a little bit of embarrassment for the Karnataka High Court, because Supreme Court has quashed their decision. Karnataka government will set up a 1152 crore rupees technology facility in Bengaluru for Boeing. Okay, this is an engineering and technology facility. This will be done by commercial aircraft maker Boeing. Boeing is a company from America. Its main rival is Airbus, and Airbus is a company from France. So this will create a lot of jobs. The Boeing facility will come up at 36 acres of land of KIADB, that is Karnataka Industrial Areas Development Board, at Aerospace Park. So Boeing has partnered with the government of Karnataka. Also, some more projects you need to know. So, you know, first is the CDC Development India. It's a company, CDC Development India. It is building a technology innovation international park on 100 acres of KIADB land at an investment of 740 crore. This was recently cleared by the Cabinet of Karnataka. CDC Development India, it is building a technology innovation international park on 100 acres of land. Also, Coast Guard's 1010 crore project to build the Indian Coast Guard Training Center on 160 acres of KIADB land in Baikamapadi, Dakshin Kannada district. This is very important. Where is the Indian Coast Guard building their training center? It is on 160 acre land in Baikamapadi, Dakshin Kannada district. So this was also shown the green light by the cabinet. And Universal Builder, this is a company, its 525 crore project, affordable housing, has also been cleared by the government. There is a housing for all scheme that has been started by the central government, under which India wants to build 6 crore houses by 2022, 4 crore in rural area, 2 crore in urban area. There is a scheme by the government of Karnataka, which is called Sheer Bhagya. Sheer means milk. So school children are provided 1 glass of milk for 5 days a week. Now Amazon will help implement Karnataka milk scheme. So Amazon will help provide, you know, Karnataka Milk Federation to implement this scheme in a better way. Sheer Bhagya. Karnataka government has signed memorandum of understanding with Google and PricewaterhouseCooper company to boost startup. This is Karnataka government's Elevate 100 program, in which Karnataka government has identified 100 startups, and they have signed MOU with 8 companies to promote these 100 startups. So this was informed by IT Minister of Karnataka, Priyank Khadge. So Elevate 100 is a government project of Karnataka, which will help elevate selected 100 startups by providing them funds and mentorship. And this is written what, which company will provide what. You don't need to go into this much detail. For example, PwC will provide monitoring and consulting. Kotak will provide, you know, finance, income tax return, and all these things. Now, in Bengaluru, 2018 Millet Fair began on 18th of January 2018. It is a 3-day workshop. It was conducted on 18th, 19th, and 20th. Organic and Millet 2018 International Trade Fair, where the farmer and all the other stakeholders, they met and they talked on a host of issues. Karnataka was the first state to introduce a organic policy in 2004 that caters to the organic value chain, etc. And remember that the millet, you know, the 2018, our central government has declared 2018 as National Year of Millet. So this was a request by Karnataka only, because Karnataka is one of the country's leader in millet sector. Karnataka has tried to attract technology people in blockchain technology hackathon. This was conducted from January 19 to January 21, 2018, recently concluded. This was regarding Karnataka wanting to use blockchain technology. Now, you know that all the cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, etc., they use blockchain technology. And Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they were the first two states in India to use blockchain technology. And Karnataka will become third state in India to use blockchain for governance. Karnataka government has, you know, fixed minimum and maximum fare for taxi, for Uber, Ola, etc. So this is D class, C class, etc. This is based on the cost of vehicle. So vehicle that cost below 5 lakh are in D class, and C class vehicle that are between 5 and 10 lakh. Then you have B class, 10 to 16 lakh, and for luxury taxi, which are above 16 lakh. There are 4 slabs. Karnataka is the first in the country to have paperless codes. Paperless code, no paper will be wasted here. So they have decided to implement something known as integrated code case management system. This will be started within next 3 years, and it will convert all the High Court of Karnataka and its benches at Hubballi and Dharwad and Kalaburgi into paperless court. So just remember that. By 2020, the project will be completed. Tobacco use in Karnataka has declined by 5.4 percentage point. This may be because of that rule. 85% of the packing has to be pictorial warning. So this was the survey that is called Global Adult Tobacco Survey 2. So in Karnataka, earlier it was 28.2. That was the percentage of adult who consumed any form of tobacco. Now it has decreased to 22.8. So in a span of 7 to 8 years, because this was conducted, GATS 1 survey was conducted in 2009-10, and now GATS 2 is conducted in 2016-17. Now Karnataka has requested Telangana. Now you can see in the map, this is Karnataka in the blue line, right? This is Karnataka. Okay. And this is Telangana. Okay, and this is Andhra. The one in the blue is Andhra. Now, this Telangana, this is Mehboob Nagar district. This one. So, you know, in Mehboob Nagar district, there is Alampur assembly seat. So, here, Karnataka will release some water. You know, Karnataka will get some water from Telangana. This is a request done by Karnataka to Telangana to release some water. So, there is Rajoli Banda diversion scheme under which Telangana will release some water. So, Telangana has a share of 3.5 TMC feet water from Tungabhadra dam, which flowed to this Rajoli Banda diversion scheme after irrigating 7,000 acres in Alampur. So Telangana has promised to release water, and in return, if Telangana falls shortage of water, then 2 TMC feet water from Narayanpur dam in Karnataka will be given to Jurala area in Telangana. So Karnataka will also reciprocate. If Telangana needs it, then Karnataka will release it from Narayanpur dam to Jurala area in Telangana. And Telangana will release it from where? From Mehboob Nagar district's Alampur assembly to Karnataka. Is it clear? Now, Karnataka cabinet has approved the bill which mandates Aadhaar. Aadhaar is now compulsory for all the availing the benefit of services. So this is called Aadhaar, Target Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies, Benefit and Services Bill 2016. There is a power plant in Karnataka by NTPC. Okay, so this has started working in Kudagi in Vijayapura. It has commenced its operations. So the capacity is 800 megawatt, but 400 megawatt will be given to Karnataka, and the remaining 400 watt will be exported to Tamil Nadu, Andhra and Telangana. So remember that. And NTPC, it has put a lot of plants across the India. And also this power plant will also get 5.2 TMC feet of water from Almaty Reservoir for its operations. Famous Kannada actor Kashinath, he passed away. He was an actor, director, filmmaker. So Kashinath, remember, he acted in a lot of Kannada films, and he was recently seen in the Kannada film Chauka. Tata's 50 megawatt solar plant in Karnataka has started. It has got green signal. It has finally started. Tata Power plant, it has been commissioned 50 megawatt DCR solar plant in Pavagada in Karnataka. So the total capacity, solar capacity installed so far in Karnataka is 1664 megawatt. So just remember that. Karnataka has banned the sale of loose cigarette. Loose cigarette means if it is in a packet, there are 10 cigarettes, you have to buy 10. You can't buy 1, 2 or 3. This will decrease the cigarette consumption because not everybody can buy the full packet, you know. So, and if you don't follow this rule, then it can be imprisonment of 1 year or fine up to 1000 rupees or both if it is for the first time. If you still do it second time, then it can be imprisonment up to 2 years and fine up to 3000 rupees. Karnataka has decided to give free education to all the girls till graduation. So from class 1 to graduation, you know, in all the public schools, that is in government school and all the aided private school, the education will be free for all the girls. This will benefit around 18 lakh girl students whose parent income is less than 10 lakh rupees. They can opt for the scheme. And for that, government will earmark 110 crore rupee. And Karnataka Education Minister is Basavaraj Rai Reddy. Karnataka has tied up with Intel's company called Mobileye. They will launch a project for automotive safety. This is called Automotive Safety Innovation. So this will help, these cameras will help, you know, gauging the distance, etc. for vehicle. And this repository that will be built by Mobileye will also be used for artificial intelligence technology, etc. Karnataka's Minister for IT, BT and Tourism is Priyank Khadge. He announced it. And Karnataka will also try to reduce the road accident. They will try to use this technology, Mobileye collision avoidance system, at potential accident zones where the chances of accident are more. Karnataka government has launched something known as Vision 2025 project, which is aimed at evolving a draft policy for the development of the state in the next 7 years, ending 2025. And for this, they will seek the opinion of the public. So for next 7 years, whatever is the development work of for the public opinion will be sought. There is a website also that is launched, which is called NavaKarnataka2025.in, where the public can voice their opinion. Now, Karnataka medical bill has been tabled and there was a lot of unhappiness in the private sector clinics. So the Karnataka health minister, Mr. K.R. Ramesh Kumar, he tabled the Karnataka private medical establishment KPME 2017. So this was after the recommendation of the joint select committee of both the houses. The health minister said that this bill is necessary and there are some objects and reasons for the bill. Reconstitute the registration and grievances redressal authority and to specify the patient's charter, and the private institutions will also follow this patient's charter, and the non-compliance will lead to severe monetary penalty. Also, emergency treatment, you know, like if there is a poor person, if he dies, any patient he dies, then the hospitals cannot, hospitals have to hand over the body to the, you know, relatives of the deceased or the dead person. They can't keep. So they can't say that first you give the bill, first you pay the bill, then we will give the body. No, they have to give the body, and they can't withhold a dead body, you know, just because the payment of the dues has not been done. Also, there are monetary penalties under the section 19, which imposes fine up to 1 lakh rupees. And there is also provision for emergency treatment without insisting on advance payment from the patient or representative of the patient in specified cases. So as soon as a patient is brought to the hospital, the treatment has to be given. Karnataka has also passed anti-superstition bill. This is called Karnataka Prevention and Eradication of Inhuman Evil Practices and Black Magic Bill. Before this, Maharashtra also passed a similar bill, if you remember. And the purpose of this bill is very simple. You ban all the superstition, which are very, very, I mean, archaic. So for example, there is a ritual called Maid Snana ritual, where the devotees, they roll on the floor over the food left over in public and religious places. But it does not ban ear piercing, astrology, vastu practices. It does not ban them. It does not ban the Shesh Lochan, Kesh Lochan practices by the Jains. And it proposes to ban killing of animal by biting its neck. The practice is called Gavu. This is an evil practice. Also, there is a ban on human sacrifice. You know, also when you force a person to perform fire walk at religious festival, that is banned. Piercing the jaw with rod is banned. Bhai Bhiga practice, pelting stones in the name of Banamati, Mata Mantra, creating panic in the mind and people by invoking ghosts, all these things are banned by this bill. So very, very important bill. Also, it bans practices against the women. For example, forcing them to stay in isolation, subjecting them to inhuman and humiliating practices such as parading them naked in the name of worship, which is called Bethal, Sav, and sexual exploitation by invoking supernatural power. there was a cabinet subcommittee that was headed by the speaker Kogadu Timappa. They drafted the bill and finally it has been passed. And if you violate the bill, then you will be penalized. You can get imprisonment of not less than 1 year and fine of not less than 5,000. There is a new biotech policy in Karnataka for 2017 to 2022. It has got approval from the government of Karnataka. It is version 3 for these 5 years. So new collaborations will take place in the biotech sector, and the biotech sector is increasing and increasing. So in 2015, Karnataka state had 35% of the total market of biotech. Total market in India is 1,26,700 crore in 2015, and Karnataka's market was 44,250. So it's a big sector in Karnataka. And the new policy, they want to have even more share of the market. So they have predicted 100 billion bioeconomy market in India, and total in the world 775 billion market. And Karnataka wants to have the maximum part of the pie. Former minister of Karnataka Kamarul Islam has passed away. He was a former minister and Muslim leader from Hyderabad, Karnataka region. He passed away. Central Groundwater Board has partnered with Indian Institute of Science Bengaluru, IISC Bengaluru, for development of groundwater flow model and preparation of aquifer management plan for the part of Karnataka which is reeling under water stress. This study will cover an area of 48,000 square kilometer comprising Chikbalapur, Kolar district as part of Bagalkot, some part of Bagalkot, Bengaluru rural, Belgaon, Bellari, Chitradurga, Davanagiri, Gadag, Gulbarga and Yadagiri district. That is where the study will be conducted. So this was the complete video from August, from July, almost some part of July to January 2018, 6 to 7 months. I hope you liked the video. I tried to cover it in a lot of depth and just try to revise again and again so that you don't miss any question. And let me know the feedback, and do share the video with your friends from Karnataka also. It will encourage me to bring more videos from Karnataka state for all of you. Thank you so much.